Hello everyone, and I just wanted to keep this video brief and talk about pre-Columbian indigenous populations, meaning before 1492. Now, a lot of people have misconceptions of facts and figures during this period because they are simply riddled in obscurity. People either consider the colonization to be a type of genocide, often conflating the spread of European disease and military campaigns, or they actively reject that anything happened with a kind of kumbaya story reminiscent of the movie Squanto.
Put down your weapons!
This video is essentially going to tackle both extremes and provide a middle ground to show that the colonization wasn't really either case. Now, the pre-Columbian population of the New World is estimated to have been between 50 to 90 million people. However, most of these population pockets were located in Mesoamerica and South America, with the latter being facilitated by the domestication of animals like the llama. This is further supported by the plethora of archaeological evidence showing the physical disparity between future Latin America and populations north of the Rio Grande. Now, I'm not rejecting the assertion that many natives were in fact killed by European colonizers, as that tended to be the case in situations like the Battle of Cajamarca, where Pizarro ambushed Incan Emperor Atahualpa in 1532. Or the Battle of Atumba in 1520, where Cortez and a handful of native auxiliaries decimated the Aztec army. What I'm trying to do is portray the complexities of colonization during this period. The Spanish also maintain outposts in the western portion of the modern United States and Florida. At this point, the extractive encomienda system was in full swing. The Spanish encomienda system was essentially indigenous serfdom, much like a tributary system. Although the system was inefficient, the availability of human capital made it very profitable for the Spanish, because indigenous populations were forced to work and pay tribute to their designated Spanish overlord. In 1607, the English tried to copy the encomienda in present-day Virginia region, but attempt after attempt failed because there was not enough human capital in the area to meet the needs of the growing colony, thus exacerbating supply difficulties that the colony was facing. Therefore, the English would have to look elsewhere for human capital,
which we don't have.
The first avenue was through indentured servitude, where poor European immigrants would work for a fixed time through a contract in hopes of obtaining land. This temporarily solved the human capital issue that the English colonies were facing in the early years, but it did nothing to alleviate the extractive nature of European colonialism. Tension between the poor migrants and rich Virginia plantation owners would escalate until 1676, when a man named Nathaniel Bacon led a rebellion against the English colonial government. Many members of this rebellion were both white and black indentured servants fighting side by side against an increasingly unfair system. The rebellion evidently came tumbling down when Bacon died of dysentery, but it marked a significant turning point in American colonial history. Noticing that they couldn't keep the indentured population under control, the English began supplementing the colony's human capital needs with chattel slavery from Africa. And boom, the African slave trade got underway, although it already existed. Now, the reason I went on this rant was to show how the lack of human capital in the Virginia colony confirms the low population estimates I gave beforehand. It really is the case that the populations north of the Rio Grande were sparse, so we have to objectively question ourselves when we talk about genocide and the dynamics of colonialism in North America. By no means am I trying to justify all European actions. Rather, I'm trying to give a level-headed explanation to a rather obscure problem. I mean, that and the fact that you can see population estimates through the ethnic makeup of modern American countries. But like I said, I just wanted to fit another piece of the puzzle.